I am a huge fan of the metric bounce rate. So as I'm putting this deck together, I did not want to recommend a metric because I fundamentally believe that there's no such thing as, oh, here are God's KPIs, and if you measure them, you're fine. That's like 10-year-old methodology, KPI, KPI, KPI. Every business is different. So my mindset is, here's the data. Here's an effective way for you to navigate the data. You figure out what's best for you, rather than me pontificating on it. This is the one exception I will make. Only exception today is a metric called bounce rate. I love it. I call it the sexiest metric ever. And the reason I like bounce rate is because it is so powerful and so, I call it brilliantly dumb. Because it's really easy to understand what a bounce rate is. There's no need for definition. Bounce rate defines this experience for your customer. I came, I puked, I left. Literally, that's the definition. The other thing is, you all spend tons of money on AdWords and direct marketing and affiliate marketing and all of those things. And what this metric can help you understand is, where are you acquiring crappy traffic from? Very quickly. So it's easy for you to go in and say, oh, what's the bounce rate on my site? 70% in this case. So a lot of people wonder why their conversion rate is 1%. Actually, for most of you, if you do e-commerce, I bet you your conversion rate is 2%. That's the average conversion rate in the United States of America, whether you're selling elephants or iPods, 2%. If you're really good at direct marketing, your conversion is probably close to 30, 35%, right? 2%. This is why your conversion rate is 2%. Is most traffic comes and leaves instantly. And yet when I do seminars or go talk to companies, I'm stunned at how few people actually know what the bounce rate of their website is. So I encourage you to do this. Now it's possible that your bounce rate is more like this, in which case it needs a love sign. Okay, this is a great bounce rate. On average, you'll find the bounce rate for your site will fall between 40 to 60%. It should probably be closer to this number. It's a great bounce rate. You cannot convince all the traffic on your website to stay. You can't. Everybody has ADD. You don't have what they want, they leave instantly. So you can't win them all, right? But that's a great bounce rate. It's a fabulous bounce rate. I was stunned that actually that's low. The next thing you want to do is you say, ah, I have all these sites, they're sending me traffic. And I think if you look at the graph, you'll notice it actually is trending up and to the right. Slowly, but it is trending up. This is good to know. This is nice. But then you can say, where is all my traffic coming from? Okay, sweet. Loveindeed.com and mail.google. Working great. I wonder what the bounce rate performance is. And they all are sending quickly unqualified traffic. So it could be I'm running the wrong campaign. It's maybe this is not a great place to go. Bounce rate is a great qualifying metric. It's a great metric that helps you ask the right questions. Exact same thing here for search. My keywords, what's my bounce rate? I can actually look at my landing pages and my bounce rate. I love this one, by the way. Definitely look at the top 20, 30 entry pages to your website where people are entering and look at the bounce rate for those pages. Because remember, your homepage is not the homepage of your website. This is where people are entering. Are these pages doing as good a job on your website as your homepage might be, where you spend a lot of love and attention, making it the perfect golden homepage in the world? But what about these pages where all these people are entering? Measure bounce rate at a site level. Measure bounce rate for your core acquisition strategies. Measure bounce rate for your top entry pages. If you're spending money on AdWords, measure bounce rate for your landing pages. It will not give you all of the answers, but will help you quickly distill down where things are not going right. And then you can say, is it that I'm bidding on the wrong keyword? Is it that the creative on my landing pages is wrong? What's going on here? It's a quick qualifying metric.